Now we are going to talk about a pelvic lesion which is quite rare. Although I'd like to emphasize that it is important to be able to have this differential diagnosis and treatments. As I mentioned in some other clips, I'm quite saddened by the fact that I see now, like in the UK, all the osteopathic colleges I know of, or most of them, have dropped teaching traditional osteopathy. So gone out of the window are differentiations between iliosacral and sacro iliac lesion. What's the difference between the two? Different type of subluxations, differential treatment. All of that is gone. It's almost what you find most of the time. It's just crack it, you know, manipulate the joint and hope for the best. It'll be all right. I'm very opposed to that because I think that when you practice in traditional terms and you use differential diagnosis, the results are so, so much better, and the joy of being able to improve people's lives is a great reward for doing that. So don't be lazy, keep up your training, keep up learning. Okay, so a superior ilium, as I said, it is a more rare lesion, but I did find it. And when only I found it 2-3 times, twice it happened that it was a colleague of mine saying, I have tried everything under the sun, you know, to manipulate this sacroiliac joint, but the person is not getting better. What on earth is it? And I have to say, you know, sometimes we get things right, sometimes we get them wrong, but I was overjoyed because in both situations, the patient was well within one treatment. And that was because I was able to do this differential diagnosis. So what happened with the superior ilium, what you will find is that the posterior superior iliac spine has gone superior, is raised. You will also find that in the front, the anterior superior iliac spine is raised. So to most people it's confusing and they can't properly diagnose it because they say if the posterior superior iliac spine is raised, what normally you will find is that in front, the anterior superior iliac spine will be inferior because there has been a forward rotation. Instead, it is also superior. Now, that of course is a great sign, an important sign that makes you think that the pelvis has shifted superiorly. And of course, when you go on to measure the crest, you again will find it on the same side that the crest has gone superiorly. And in my experience, I have to say that the treatment is very, very simple. You do some preparatory techniques like, you know, rotating. I strongly advise you to do a few techniques like putting your hand under the sacroiliac area and doing, you know, various rotations, softening the area. And I have shown, if you look at the playlist in my channel on treatments for the lower back, you have so many techniques you can use. So make sure that the lower back and the sacroiliac joint has been loosened. So in that case, then it's quite easy to practice this. And what I've done on both situations is this simple. Gently take the leg, I bring it up, 1, 2, bring it down, and oops, a tug. You know, about twice you do it, just a quick tug, and that very often it's enough to achieve the result. You can also use a muscle energy technique in which you ask the patient to pull the leg towards them. I mean, to pull, you know, with my hand, I push down, and as I push down, she pushes against me, against my push. So I'm pushing caudate, she pushes cephalad, meaning I'm pushing against, towards her feet, and she's pushing towards her head. So I resist. She's only using a third of her strength. I resist, count till about 10, and then you relax and you push a little bit further down to take the slack caused by this contraction, and you repeat the same twice. I'm not doing it now, of course, because if I did that, I'll just create, you know, a longer leg on the right side, which is quite pointless. And but this is these two are the best techniques to treat a superior ilium. As I said, a rare condition, but is great if you know how to treat it when it presents itself to you. Thanks for watching.